Hear ye, hear ye. Come one and all to this display presented by the theater troupe of Dannenberg High School. Martin G. Humor Splendid tonight. My name is Diego Tamayo, and I am your drama department vice president.
Or, for you commoners who don't understand, welcome to the Shakespeare Cabaret, brought to you by the Dannenberg High School Theater Department. Aren't you feeling splendid tonight? My name is Allison Marie Santagrossi, and I'm your drama department president.
Tonight's assortment of songs, scenes, and monologues are inspired by and or derived from the various works of the masterful poet, writer, and actor himself, William Shakespeare of England. The 17th century is coming alive in 2020. How enlightening.
If you haven't already, make sure to order a burrito, taco, or whatever your heart desires from Chipotle. Just go to this website and enter this code to order a meal. Not only will you be getting a delicious meal, but you'll also be supporting your favorite drama department. Now, we have some really fun activities planned tonight, and for our first, we have a Guess the Musical through Emojis. So, for this musical, we have a couple of guys dancing, we have a writing hand, we have a stack of books, the drama masks, some musical notes, a dancer, and a fried egg. Can you guess what musical it is? You guessed Something Rotten, you're correct. Something Rotten is a show about two brothers who are in a bitter feud with William Shakespeare as they attempt to write a show more popular than the one and only Bards. Did you know that in real life, Shakespeare's own parents couldn't read or write? So I guess where he got the writing gene will always be a mystery. Singing God, I Hate Shakespeare from Something Rotten, here's Spencer.
Oh, God, I hate Shakespeare.
No,
that's right, I said it. I hate Shakespeare.
Why?
I just don't get it. How a mediocre actor from a measly little town is suddenly the brightest role in England's royal crown. Oh, God, I hate Shakespeare. These plays are wordy, but oh no, the great Shakespeare. That little turkey has no sense about the audience. He makes it feel so dumb. Pastor doesn't know that my poor ass is getting numb. How can you say that? How can you say that? It's easy, I can say it, cause it's absolutely true. Don't be a weenus, the man is a genius. His genius is he's fooling all of you. But he's brilliant, what majesty flows from his pen. His poetry soars like a sweet violin. God's own inspiration, like lightning does strike him. And he captures my soul. Ah, jeez, you sound just like him.
Really?
Thanks. You should hate Shakespeare. Well, I don't. I try to emulate Shakespeare. Well, there's your problem. You're so blinded by the bard, such a pompous little man.
Why is it a problem to admit him a fan?
Because he's a hack with the knack for stealing anything he can.
How can you say that? How can you say that the man really knows how to write a freaking play? You wish you could pen one. We wish we were in one.
I just wish that he would go away.
Well, that's not gonna happen because everybody I know says that he's the greatest writer that England has ever known.
And that's another thing I hate about Shakespeare is all the twits who bloviate about Shakespeare and how they prattle on about his great accomplishments and la-di-da-di-da. And once they start their gushing, there's no stopping them, and then it's blah 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 Shakespeare. He walks in and da-da-da-da-da Shakespeare. He's holding court and they say, Will, you're such a genius and your writing is divine. A rose by any other name is such a clever line. And they're like, ooh, and he's all stop. And they're like, yay, and I'm like, ugh. I'm really getting sick of it, and I hate Shakespeare. I think by now we sort of know you hate Shakespeare. Shakespeare, the way he feigns humility when all he does is gloat. The way he wears that silly frilly collar around his throat. The poster child for why no one should ever procreate. I mean, make a shorter list and I will give it to you straight. Every little thing about Shakespeare is what I hate. Really, truly, really, truly hate Shakespeare. Don't hate.
Thank you, Spencer. Next, we will go to an monologue that Allison is performing. But before then, let's play another emoji game. flag of Denmark, a crown, a spooky ghost, a skull, some clashing swords, and yes, another skull. What musical would that be? I mean, play. If you guessed correctly, the play would be Hamlet. Hamlet was among the most popular of plays during Shakespeare's own time, and has remained his most produced play to this day. The tragic plot lines, the artistic mastery, and dynamic complex characters have made this five-hour-long play among the most well-regarded of all his works. So, don't forget that he's also the rightful heir to the timeless phrase, to be or not to be. Now we will be presenting Ophelia's monologue from Hamlet by Alison Egress.
What a noble mind is here o'erthrown. Oh, the courtiers, scholars, soldiers, aye, tongue, sword, the expectancy and rose of the fair state, the glass of fashion and the mold of form, the observed of all observers, quite down. And I, of ladies most dejected and wretched, that sucked the honey of his music vows, now see that most noble and sovereign reason, like sweet bells, jangled out of tune and harsh. The unmatched form and feature of blown youth, blasted with ecstasy. Oh, woe is me. To have seen what I have seen. To see what I see.
Thank you, Allison. Next, we will move on to another song, but before then, let's play another emoji trivia. Can you guess from which musical these two emojis come from? A lion, and a crown. If you guess The Lion King, then you are correct. The Lion King animated film's original opening scene featured a dialogue introducing most of the show's main characters. But the director scrapped this plan when they heard the final version of The Circle of Life. They felt strongly compelled to instead make this musical piece the opening to this beloved film. Now, without further ado, The Circle of Life from The Lion King by Caitlin.
Path of unwinding.
Thank you, Caitlin. Next up, we have another piece from The Lion King. Did you know that the tragic story of Simba in The Lion King follows numerous parallels to the tragic demise of Prince Hamlet from Shakespeare's tragedy Hamlet? Introducing Asamiko and Jessica, singing I Just Can't Wait to Be King from The Lion King.
So little hair.
Gonna be the main event, like looking with the boy. I'm brushing up on looking down, I'm working on my roy.
Thus far, a rather uninspiring thing.
Oh, I just can't wait to be a king.
You've rather a long way to go, young master, if you think.
No one say do this.
No one say be there.
No one say stop that.
No one say see here.
Read and run around all day.
Well, that's definitely out.
Read it, do it all my way.
I think it's time that you and I arranged a heart to heart.
Kings who need advice from little Hondas for a start.
This is where the monarchy is headed. Count me out. Out of service, out of Africa, I wouldn't hang about. This child's getting wildly out of me.
Oh, I just can't wait to be king. Everybody look left.
Everybody look right.
Every look I'm standing spotlight.
Not yet.
Let every creature go for broken things.
Let's get in the heart and on the wing. It's gonna be King's Emma's finest fling.
Oh, I just can't wait to be king.
Thank you, Asamiko and Jessica. Next up, we have a scene from A Midsummer Night's Dream presented by our Diamond Thespians, our drama club for WVSD middle schoolers. Did you know that three of Uranus's moons are named after characters from A Midsummer Night's Dream? After being discovered in 1985, they were named Puck, Oberon, and Titania, after the lead characters in the Shakespearean comedy. Now, give it up for our Diamond Thespians performing a scene from A Midsummer Night's Dream, directed by yours truly and Diego Tamayo.
Is all our company here?
You were the best to call them generally, man by man, according to the script.
Here's the scroll of every man's name, which is through fit through all Athens to play in our interlude before the Duke and the Duchess on his wedding day at night.
First, good Peter Quince, say what the play treats on, then read the names of the actors, and so grow to a point.
Mary, our play is the most lamentable comedy and the most crude death of Pyramus and Thisbe.
A very good piece of work, I assure you, and a Mary. Now, good Peter Quince, call forth your actors by the scroll. Masters, spread yourselves.
Answer as I call you. Nick Bottom, the Weaver.
Ready. Name what part I am for, and proceed.
You, Nick Bottom, are set down for Pyramus.
What is Pyramus, a lover or a tyrant?
A lover that kills himself most gallant for love.
That will ask some tears in the true performing of it. If I do, let the audience look to their eyes. I will move storms. I will cajole in some tyrant. I could play Hercules, rare or a part to a tear cat in, to make all split. The raging rocks and shivering shocks shall break the locks of the prison gates. And Phoebus' car shall shine from far and make and mar the foolish fates. This was lofty. Now name the rest of the players. This is Hercules' vein, a tyrant's vein, a lover is more condoling.
Francis Flute, the bellows mender.
Here, Peter Quinch.
Flute, you must take this beyond you.
Could this be a wandering knight?
It is the lady that Pyramus must love.
Nay, faith, let me not play a woman. I have a beard coming.
That's all one. You shall play in a mask, and you may speak as small as you will.
And I may hide my face. Let me play Thisbe, too. I'll speak in a monstrous little voice. Thisney, Thisney. As, Pyramus, lover dear, the Thisbe dear, and lady dear.
No, no, you must play Pyramus, and Flute, you Thisbe.
Well, proceed.
Robin Starveling, the tailor.
Here, Peter Quinch.
Robin Starveling, you must play Thisbe's mother. Slug the joiner, you the lion's part, and I hope here is a play fitted.
Have you the lion's part written? Pray you, if it be given it me, for I am slow of study.
You may do it extemporate, for it is nothing but roaring.
And let me play the lion too. I will roar that I will do any man's heart good to hear me. I will roar that I will make the duke say, let him roar again, let him roar again.
And you should do it too terribly. You would fright the duchess and the ladies, that they would shriek, and that were enough to hang us all.
That will hang us, every mother's son.
I grant you, friends, if that you should fright the ladies out of their wits, they would have no more discretion but to hang us. But I will aggravate my voice so that I will roar you as gently as any sucking dove. I will roar you as tweer any nightingale.
You can play no part but Pyramus, for Pyramus is a sweet-faced man, a proper man, as one shall see in a summer's day, a most lovely gentleman-like man. Therefore, you must needs play Pyramus.
Well, I will undertake it.
Masters, here are your parts. And I am to entreat you, request you, and desire you to come them by tomorrow night and meet me in the palace wood, a mile without the town, by moonlight. There we will rehearse, for if we meet in the city, we shall be dodged but with company, and our device is known. In the meantime, I will draw a bill of properties, such as our play wants. I pray you, fail me not.
We will meet, and there we will rehearse, the most obscenely and courageously. Take pains, be perfect. Adieu.
And now we have reached our intermission. Make sure to take these next few minutes to run to the bathroom, grab some water, anything you might need to do. But for now, I'm going to tell you about some upcoming shows we have. So on October 7th, we have our Dark Side Cabaret, which is featuring some of our favorite villain songs and monologues. After that, we have our fall play production called Get a Clue, and that will be on October 23rd and 24th. Then we have a Grim Retelling, which is a collaboration with our DBHS dance department, and that will be on October 30th. After that, we have our Dream Rolls Cabaret, our Winter Cabaret, our Christmas Carol, and the Nutcracker. To learn more about those shows, make sure to visit our website, dbhstheater.com.
Here I have a humble request of the audience. Please, please donate to support the Dunbar Theater Department. Dunbar High School Theater Department. Several pounds, some shillings, and certainly sixpence will be greatly appreciated. Oh, this isn't old England anymore. My mistake. The standard US dollar, I suppose, would also be an acceptable form of currency for donations. In order to donate, please click on the link at the corner of your screen. Thank you.
In a world where Simba will be the next king of the savannah, there is one lion standing in his way, Scar.
Oh, my offense is rank. It smells to heaven. It hath the primal eldest curse upon it. A brother's murder. Goodbye, Mufasa.
With his father gone, Simba must learn to fend for himself.
The lion that did sting thy father Mufasa's life now wears his crown.
Simba is on the verge of losing everything.
To roar or not to roar, that is the question.
He pushes away everyone he loves.
Get thee to a zoo and quickly too.
Without her love by her side, Nala descends into madness. Ah! What will become of Simba? Find out this summer by watching Simba, the Lion King of Denmark. Summer 2021.
Now we will move on to our next song. But before then, let's do some more emoji trivia. Can you guess from which musical these different emojis come from? A kiss. The theater, the princess, and the dancing lady. If you guessed Kiss Me, Kate, you are correct. This show's concept of backstage bickering between a husband and a wife was based off of a real-life theatrical duo, Alfred Lunt and Lynn Fontanne. In 1935, they starred together in a production of Shakespeare's Taming of the Shrew. Now is the song, I Am Ashamed People Are So Simple, by Bella.
I am ashamed the people are so simple. To offer war when we should kneel for peace, or seek for rule, supremacy, and sway, when everything but love must die away. Why are our bodies finite, bound for dust? A time we share so brief and yet so dear, if not to teach our proud and stubborn hearts to love the best we can while we are here. So mates, hold your temper and humbly put your hand beneath the soul of your lover's foot, in token of which duty, if he please. My hand is ready, ready. May it do.
Great job, Bella. Now we have another song from Kiss Me, Kate. Ironically, the plot of the show Kiss Me, Kate revolves heavily around the Shakespearean comedy Taming of the Shrew, because the show is set in a production of this play being produced on stage. Now, presenting Alyssa singing So in Love from Kiss Me, Kate.
Strange dear, but true dear, when I
Thank you, Alyssa. And now for another round of Guess That Play. So, we have a couple of guys dancing. We have an airplane, an Italian flag, a woman, a face with hard eyes, a sad face, and two couples kissing. Can you guess what play this is? If you guessed The Two Gentlemen of Verona, you're correct. Shakespeare had a notable legacy of playwriting, but did you know that it all started from somewhere? Tis indeed true. The first play Shakespeare wrote that would influence the rest of his writings is believed to be his very first comedy, The Two Gentlemen of Verona. Now, introducing Diego, performing a monologue from Act 3, Scene 3 of The Two Gentlemen of Verona.
Nay, 'twill be this hour ere I've done weeping. All the kind of the lances have this very fault. I have received my proportion, like the prodigious son, and I am going with Sir Proteus to the Imperial's court. I think Crab, my dog, be the sourest natured dog that lives. My mother weeping, my father wailing, my sister crying, our maid howling, our cat wringing her hands, and our house in a great perplexity. Yet did not this cruel-hearted cur shed one tear. He is a stone, a very pebble stone, and has no more pity in him than a dog. A Jew would have wept to have seen our parting. Why, my grandam, having no eyes, look you, wept herself blind at my parting. Nay, I'll show you the manner of it. This shoe is my father. No. This left shoe is my mother. Nay, that cannot be so, neither. Yes, it is so. It is so. It hath the worser soul. The shoe with the hole in it is my mother, and this my father. A vengeance on it. There it is. Now, sit, sit. This staff is my sister. For look you, she is as white as a lily and as small as a wand. This hat is Nan, our maid. I am the dog. No. The dog is himself, and I am the dog. Oh, the dog is me, and I am myself. So. Now, I come to my father. Father, your blessing. Now, should I not the shoes speak a word for weeping? Now I should kiss my father. Well, he weeps on. Now I come to my mother. Oh, that she could speak now like a wood woman. Well, I kiss her. Why, there. Here's my mother's breath up and down. Now I come to my sister. Mark the moan she makes. Now the dog all this while sheds not a single tear, nor speaks a word, but see how I lay the dust with my tears.
Yours truly. Now we will be hearing from another performance, but before then, let's play some more emoji trivia. Can you guess from which musical these emojis come from? A guy rocking a cowboy hat, an electric guitar, a motorcycle, one couple, and yet another couple. If you guessed All Shook Up, then you are correct. This show is based on Shakespeare's play Twelfth Night, which is about a girl who disguises herself as a boy and must help her true love win the affection of another woman. In Shakespeare's day, women were not allowed to act on stage, meaning that the part of Viola would have been played by a man who was pretending to be a woman who was pretending to be a man. Have fun watching Sarai perform Don't Be Cruel from All Shook Up while I keep trying to figure that out.
Candy found, sent home all alone. I come around? Please, please, telephone, don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Maybe if I made you mad for something I might have said, please forget the past. The future look bright ahead. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. I don't want no other love. Baby, it's just you I'm thinking of.
Your turn. Shake it.
Don't stop thinking of me to make me feel this way. Come on over here and love me. You know what I want you to say. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Should we be apart? I really love you, baby. Cross my heart. So walk up to the preacher and let's say I do. Then you'll know you love me, and I know I love you. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. I don't want no other love. Baby, it's just you I'm thinking of. Don't want no other love. Baby, it's just you I'm thinking of.
Thank you, Sarai. Now for another round of emoji trivia. Can you guess what musical this is? Here we have the Vietnamese flag, a couple in love, a helicopter, and a baby. If you guessed the musical Miss Saigon, then you are correct. Didst thou know that in the Broadway production of Miss Saigon, there's a real life helicopter that appears on stage in act two of the show? Enjoy watching Anna singing I Give My Life for You from Miss Saigon.
I cradled in my arms, you asking as little as you can. Little snip of a little man. I swear I'd give my life for you. You didn't ask me to. Why should you learn a bore or a pain?
you, Anna. And now for another round of emoji trivia. Here we have a cityscape, a man dancing, an American flag, a Puerto Rican flag, a couple in love, a gun, and a soul. If you guessed West Side Story, then you're correct. Did you know that during rehearsals for West Side Story, the groups of actors playing members of the two rival gangs, Sharks and the Jets, were prohibited from interacting with each other? The show's director, Hal Prince, kept them as far away from each other as possible during rehearsals. And during their breaks, they weren't even allowed to eat lunch together. Now, enjoy Jillian's performance of Tonight from West Side Story.
Tonight, it all began tonight. I saw you and the world went away. Tonight, tonight, there's only you tonight. What you are, what you do, what you say. What was just a world is a story tonight. Tonight, tonight, the world is full of light. With suns and moons all over the place. Tonight, tonight, our world is wild and bright. Going mad, shooting sparks into space. Today, our world was just an address, a place for me to live. And what was just a world is a story tonight.
Thank you, Jillian. And now for the final number of the night, we are going to have Olivia perform Right Hand Man from Something Rotten. Creative talent from half a dozen shows, including The Book of Mormon, Avenue Q, Aladdin, Rent, Motown, and In the Heights, are involved in the creation of this musical. Olivia, take it away.
If you ever got in trouble, I would be there on the double just to bail you out. If there's anything you lack, you know I've always got your back. That's what it's all about. Think of me as your sidekick, helping you whenever I can. I am more than just a woman, baby. When the pressure's coming, baby, let me be your right hand man. Well, I can be the man too. If you're ever in a pickle, you can call for me and quickle be how fast I run. You need to be a team for any dream or any scheme, that's how it should be done. Sure, I could stay in the background, just smiling every now and again. But just to be a pretty lady, that would be a pity, baby, let me be your right-hand man.